Here are some stocks to watch out for. We are monitoring shares of Ulta Beauty after it missed top and bottom line expectations in the second quarter. Shares of the Warren Buffett-backed company sank 8% in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of Lululemon Athletica after it reported better than expected earnings. Shares of the athletic apparel retailer jumped 4%. We are also keeping a close watch on shares of Dell Technologies after second quarter results topped Wall Street estimates. That's thanks to record revenue in its infrastructure solution business. Its stock rose 6% before the bell. We're also keeping a close eye on shares of Intel, which is reportedly considering restructuring options as a chipmaker tries to weather a sharp slowdown. Investors welcome this development, sending Intel shares higher by 3%. Asian markets closed out the ghost month on a strong note following a volatile August that was marked by U.S. recession fears and worries about rate cuts. Markets were calmed on Friday by fresh U.S. economic data that suggested the Federal Reserve is engineering a so-called soft landing for the world's biggest economy. Japan's Nikkei 225 logged a monthly gain of 0.33%, despite seeing its biggest single-day rout since the 1987 Black Monday sell-off last August 6. The Hong Kong Hang Seng and Australia's ASX 200 also posting monthly gains. Here at home, the local bourse closed flat for the day, but managed a 4% monthly gain.
August was a dynamic month for the local equities. It's actually characterized by a mix of optimism and caution. There are still a lot of uncertainties. So I think that it could open some opportunities for some traders, of course, because we could see some action on industries that would be benefited by the additional anticipated rate cuts from the BSP, because of course, should there be another rate cut, borrowing costs would be lowered and sentiment generally will improve. So I think that the banking, real estate and consumer discretionary sectors would see some interesting action for the month of September.
As for the Philippine peso, it hit a five-month high against the U.S. dollar, closing at 56.11 Friday. The local currency touched a 56 to the dollar level this month as a greenback took a beating from firmer bets of a Fed rate cut, while the peso has been getting a boost from easing local inflation and recent credit rating upgrades. Bank lending in the Philippines expands 10.4% in July. That's according to preliminary data from the BSP, which cites growth in outstanding loans to residents and non-residents, as well as in production activities. Growth in production activities was driven by lending to major sectors such as real estate, manufacturing, and logistics, among others.